Hi guys, welcome to Printride. I'm your host Ranveer, and today in this video we are going to demonstrate you or show you how to do water-based printing with the help of your light garment paste or LGP. So you know, I told you in a previous video about some of the water-based products. So what light garment paste, you can do printing only in light garments. Suppose this is a gray color, here you can print black or white color or like sky blue, yellow, any color where you are not using white. In this thing you can do white also as well as black, but this light garment paste is only for garments that are light in color and where you are not using white color. So that's keep in mind. So, and this product, like this print, you will have zero feel in your printing. You will not feel that you have any printing in your garments, or you will not feel in your t-shirts. It will be fully dissolved. The print will fully get dissolved in your garment, and the garment print will be equal. So for first of all, that last time I told you about different product, so I will do one thing. I will just recollect the product and I'll tell you again what all the things are that, so that you have some idea according to that. So first of all, we require light garment paste. This light garment paste is the agent where you will mix your pigment ink, where you will be mixing your pigment ink, because water-based ink or pigment ink are fully liquid in form. So when liquid form, you put in your screen, you can't able to print because it is fully liquid. And this light garment paste is thick like cream. So when you are going to do printing, your product should be in a creamy texture so that you can do the printing. So this creamy texture will be mixed with the pigmenting and we'll go for the printing. So for your help, these are packaging for our printing pigment inks, but I will take a transparent bottle so that you can get it nicely. So first of all, this is LGP, light garment paste. First, and while you are doing the mixing, this thing will be around, suppose you are doing 1 kg of ink, 1 kg of colors you want, or ready paste you want. So in 1 kg, you have to give 950 grams of this only. The ratio is 100 by 5 to 10% by 3%. So if you have 1 kg of LGP with you, then the pigment ink should be around 5 to 10% according to your desired color, according to your tone of the color. And the fixer is you have to give for 3%. Fixer is the sticky agent that will help the paste to get stick with your garment. So, and remember, don't put more fixer. It is exactly, you have to give 2 to 3%. You can't go above that, otherwise you will get choke in your screen. So always use a weighting scale like this and give the fixer in a appropriate manner according to your paste. And after, if you are doing for large quantity, like you are going for 5 kgs, 10 kgs of colors, don't mix the fixer at a time. Because if you mix the fixer at a time, after 6 to 12 hours, it will get dried. So you have to print, you have to complete your print job within 6 to 12 hours. Suppose, once the fixer is mixed with a paste or ready paste, the print job should be completed within 6 to 12 hours. So suppose you have huge quantity or whatever you have, Mix the ready paste and the pigmenting how much you want. You can mix. You can store it for 1 year, no issue. But you take a little portion, like half kg, 1 kg, put the fixer, mix it and print, so that there is no wastage of products or materials. So we'll start. First of all, we'll take a container. After that, we'll put around 100 grams of light garment paste. So we'll open our light garment paste. After opening our light garment paste, we'll take some of our light garment paste in a container, and it should not be more than 100 grams because we are going to go 100 gram mixing of garment. Sorry, light garment paste. So we have given the paste, it's around 75 gram now. So we are putting some more and we'll make it 100. It's now 92 gram and 100. It is like at 100 gram. After this, now we'll put the pigmenting. Pigmenting will be around 5% to 10% according to your desired depth of the color. So I will go for 5%. Because I just tried this very strong color, this is a coffee red, so it is very strong. So 5% is more than enough. Yes. Now we'll go for the fixer. Fixer. We'll go for 3% exactly because we have taken 100 grams of light garment paste. It's 2%. Yes, now it is 3%. So now the paste is ready. This thing we can use for next 6 to 12 hours. So now we'll mix it well so that it will take the form of the color. See, it's changing its color from white, is getting coffee red or blood red. Mix it nicely. So our mixing is done, our pigmenting is ready to print. After mixing the paste, ready for print. I already have put some of the ink here, it's ready for print. So I'll keep it aside. First of all, we'll spray it up so that we'll get nice print. Now we'll take one garment. We are taking a gray garment today because we used it a couple of times. Like we have used lots of gray because gray is a garment. It can be used for light, dark, white, black, whatever print you want. So we put the garment here and we'll do the printing. So we'll first of all make it even, flat, so that we doesn't have any wrinkles in the middle while printing. After that, we'll do the printing. And if you don't know how to print or how to squeeze it up, then click on the I button, take my previous videos, how to do single color printing, multicolor printing, all these things. So we take a frame down and we'll take a squeezy water based, you in plastic soil you have to give some of your energy, but water based is like water, no need to give any energy. So we'll just squeeze it up, print, take it up, flood, again print. So like that, flood and print. This is how you have to do. So the print is done. Now we'll go for curing. We'll put in the flasher. So in water base, always remember, I'll show you one more time. When you are printing, after printing, flood, then print, then flood again. You can't keep your screen open, otherwise it will get dry. While after some time it will get dry, it will choke or you will get clogs in your screen. So print, flood. Now we put in our flasher to dry. So like around 15 seconds, 10 to 15 seconds, it will get dry. But after drying, don't forget to cure it by putting it in the heat press, your fusing machine or conveyor, what you have. So our print is done. It's semi-dried now, but don't forget to put the heat press. So I won't show you now. But if you don't know how to put a heat press or don't know how to do curing, check in our description box about curing videos. We'll give a link of the curing videos. So I'll put it in the heat press. So we have heat press it. Now our print Bob Marley is alive. See, you'll get return no fill print with water base. Means you won't get any feeling or any feel of the print with your water base print. It's very cool and very comfortable, like any of the hot climate, summertime, whatever. Like the summertime, you don't want to wear plastic shell that much. Then the water base is very comfortable in wearing because you not feel any substance or any heat in your garment. So I think you already came to know how to print a water base and how to mix it. Hope this gave you some knowledge about the print. So like our video, subscribe our channel, and don't forget to press the bell icon so that you get the notification fast. And do support us so that we can keep continue making this type of video. So as I say you always, stay tuned. See you soon.